Africa, of course, has got a big chance to feed itself, but to do that, you've got to engage the entire population. It can't just be done with big projects, and it can't be done just by the commercial farmers that we see today. Rural participation, obviously from social reasons, is important for us, but also from practical reasons, to get the rural population involved and drive efficiency in smaller farms is just as important as driving big projects.
All right. At this moment, what is the rate for food demand in Africa? How high has this gone? Of course, considering that the population is ever growing and it's one of the right. fastest growing.
Yeah, no. Knowing that the population is going to double again in the next 25 years or so is I think, a call to action for not just industrial companies like ourselves that are in the business, but every facet of the agribusiness sector needs to be looking at what we do to help support the growth of African agriculture. You're right, it's already a big business, but it's one that will be growing fast only to feed its own population. And we believe strongly, given the amount of arable land that's still not being used in Africa, and the fact that this land is pretty fertile and it has water available, there's no reason that Africa can't feed itself plus be a net exporter of agricultural products in the future.
Talk to me about this new innovation that was launched at the International Week, of course, for agribusiness there in Berlin. What new factor does it bring to the table for agribusiness men?
So we have just launched a new system for agricultural improvement and agricultural production that's called Farm in a Box. And to an extent, it is what it sounds like. We have a one source that would have mechanization solutions in it for virtually every season of the year, 3 years worth of parts. And maybe the most interesting thing about it, where we always thought that African farming involved having a simple product and a straightforward and efficient sort of product that you use, this is more about putting technology to work for us as well. So we have taken an 80 horsepower tractor, and we have a full load of telemetry already built into it to understand what the tractor is doing, where it is, who's using it, is it being used efficiently, is it being used for the right process for that period of time, and being able to monitor that both through some of our partners that would be local, but also on an African continental basis in our offices in Johannesburg in South Africa.
All right.
So this, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Now this gives us a kind of an unusual platform compared to what's been offered in Africa before, that with a franchisee and the right sort of training that goes along with using the product, we believe that what we can do is to offer units of time on that tractor or that mechanization tool. That will make it easier for the smallholder farmer, the rural African farmer, to be able to utilize the tools of mechanization that are so important when you start looking at productivity increases and yield increases that you can do on a farm. And it's just about optimizing the opportunity that you have for every hectare of soil and making sure that you're using that the right way. And getting the output out of it that's possible.
All right. Gary, of course, we understand that this new innovation, of course, comes in to help farmers solve some of the challenges that they're facing right now as mechanization, market access, skills development, and inputs. But much of my focus rather here that I want to hear from you as well is that the biggest constraint to agricultural growth or the sector growth around the continent is hindered by access to credit. Like creditors
right.
cannot find agriculture viable for all of the money to be spent into and have no way to actually track the funding. Tell me, is there a way that this system could actually support that rather conversation?
Yeah, we feel very strongly that one, this can have a very good business case for the partner, the contractor, what do you call them, a franchisee that works with us on the farm in a box. So one thing is that you've got a stronger person that has a stronger credit person that has the ability to offer sustainable service and parts to this piece of machinery. But more importantly, you get a lot more leverage out of the investment because with the work that's already been done in many cases in Africa of putting farmers together in a co-op sort of arrangement, you can make sure that, one, you keep that machine very busy throughout the co-op, and second, each of the co-op member farmers doesn't have to invest in a machine himself. He can invest in an hour or 10 hours or whatever it takes in order to run the right processes during that time of the year. He can invest in what he needs. So the high investment for a farmer is machinery, seed, other inputs such as fertilizer, those types of things that he can avoid some of the biggest of his investments in machinery by using this franchisee partner as his source for mechanization.
Mm. To what point do you see the growing youth population contributing or happening to be an opportunity for the agribusiness in the continent, on the continent?
We see it as again a huge asset that needs to be utilized in the right way. The first thing for that is for upskilling those young people and women to be in the market and understand what they're doing. It's way more than just operator training, but of course we can do that. But it's agronomic skills and it's some commercial skills as well to understand how the markets work and help themselves, if you will. We have a growing population and high youth, and with youth comes the ability to work hard and as long as you know what you're doing, get a return from that. And we think the training that we do along with the Farmer to Box concept can go a long ways into upskilling that youth base of labor to making them effective and productive in the agricultural markets.
And what is the future holding for agribusiness? That'll be my last one.
The future for agribusiness, again, I think is very bright in Africa. Again, the basics are here. Fertile soil that's not being used well enough now, and water in order to feed it. And of course, parts of the world are going through drought. Africa, in sub-Saharan Africa, water is plentiful and we have good land. So from that standpoint, we have an opportunity. On top of that, we have the growing market that the population brings. And not just an opportunity, but an obligation, I think, for companies like ourselves to be in it and find solutions that can help the African population feed itself, one, and become an economic power.